Next, we meet a British man who has become famous in China for his talent in singing traditional Chinese political and revolutionary songs.
有请零二号伊恩带来《打靶归来》。
日落西山红霞飞。
35-year-old Ian Inglis is perhaps one of the few non-Chinese who enjoys singing Chinese red songs. Red songs are a genre of songs that focus on praise for the Communist Party of China and the Chinese government. He may have grown up in Britain, but Ian has always been fascinated by socialist countries such as China, Russia and Vietnam.
I grew up, or some of my childhood, was during the Cold War. And, of course, in our official media, we were often told that they are bad or they are our enemies, and I didn't understand why. So I just became interested in this issue. Why are they bad? And I just, through that, I began to find out more about it. And I found out actually that, well, they're not really bad. They're just a bit different. And that interested me, yeah.
During his previous visits to the DPRK, Vietnam and other socialist countries, he's collected various souvenirs, which he proudly displays on the wall of his house in Sanya, in southern China's Hainan province.
Okay, so if you look up here on the wall, we have some pictures of, let's say, communist icons: Karl Marx, Friedrich Engels, Lenin, Stalin, Mao Zedong, Zhou Enlai. Yeah. And then if you come down, we have a few items in here that I've collected over the years. For example, a little bust of Mao Zedong, just here. I bought that in Ruijin, in Jiangxi province. Here we have a little book that's telling about this man here, Lei Feng, and sometimes I dress like him when I'm singing songs.
At school, Inglis enjoyed studying the politics and history of Russia, Germany and the Czech Republic. At the age of 14, he learned his first ever socialist song, the national anthem of the Soviet Union.
The reason I learned that was because I was learning Russian at the time, and my Russian teacher was from the former Soviet Union. She was from Lithuania, and she... I can't remember where. I heard the music of that song somewhere, and I asked her about it, and she thought it would be a good exercise to write the lyrics to the song and learn it, because I like the music. So she said, if you're interested, then why don't you just learn this?
Perhaps it was this song that inspired his love for revolutionary songs. In 2003, after returning from his holiday in China, Inglis met a Chinese woman on a flight from Shanghai to Hokkaido in Japan. This lady would later become his wife. It was during that same year that he learned his first Chinese red song.
The first Chinese song that I ever learned was on a CD, or in fact a VCD, that I had bought in the summer of 2003 in China. I bought it and I took it back to Japan. And that year, I remember, I slowly taught myself an old Chinese song called 社会主义好, which in English, I guess, is Socialism is Good, which was a song from, I think, the 1950s, singing about socialism and how we need to build up socialism in China. It's a very simple song, and actually the tune's quite nice, and it's quite catchy, so I learned that very quickly.
A year later, after his wife had returned to China, Inglis had made the decision to stay. He found a job as a teacher in a college in Suzhou, in East China's Jiangsu province. Inglis never dreamed that his talent in singing Chinese red songs would one day make him a celebrity. But in 2004, he was invited to appear on a TV show for a Suzhou TV station.
My supervisor asked me, would you like to attend? And I thought, I can't do anything. She says, well, you can't do anything? And I thought, well, I can sing Socialism is Good. Great. So I applied and I enrolled in the competition. I went there and I sang and I got the prize for most popular act.
In 2007, Inglis and his wife moved to Sanya, where he was offered a position as a customer service manager at a hotel. 2 years later, some of his friends encouraged him to take part in a competition called the China Red Song Show, which was to be held in the eastern province of Jiangxi. He won the fifth place in the contest and became nicknamed the Red Foreigner.
Jiangxi province, I can say I was very famous at that time because, in China, predominantly local people will watch the local television station. And so a lot of Jiangxi people watched the Red Song competition as it was broadcast by their local television station. And it was very popular in Jiangxi.
Inglis's life has changed a lot since then. After the competition, he received a number of invitations from places across China, wanting him to perform his red songs.
I learned the songs simply because I wanted to learn them. I didn't learn them for other people, you know, I learned them for myself. And it was only after I entered a local competition that I realized some people like to hear my songs. And, well, they're not my songs, they're Chinese, you know, revolutionary songs. But, it just sort of snowballed from there. It got bigger and bigger, and I didn't intend any of it.
Inglis then decided to quit his job and make a career as a professional performer. He even bought a Mao suit and dressed like a Chinese soldier from the 1950s. In 2011, he travelled to Shanghai to perform on China's Got Talent.
Perhaps people like to watch me more than they like to listen to me because, you know, I don't sing beautifully. But I think perhaps the image of a foreigner, someone who's very obviously foreign, a European, on the stage, dressed in traditional, perhaps 1930s, 40s Chinese Red Army uniform, singing songs from that period. With a bit of oomph, a bit of gusto there. They think it's something they've never seen before, and I think it's sort of new and interesting and a bit exciting.
Besides performing on the stage, Inglis has also recently been invited to be a guest judge on a TV competition show. He's so content with his life in China that he's now even planning to apply for permanent residence here. Speaking of his plans for the future, he says he hopes to have the chance to perform his red songs in more regions across China, including Xinjiang, Tibet, and Inner Mongolia.